So, I'm sure this was not one a lot of people were expecting to pop up so soon. I'm still kind of working out my current upload schedule and how I want to do games. So even though I have the quest currently ongoing, I decided to avoid burnout because I am 10 hours deep into that game as of this recording, that I'm going to have a revisit. Let's revisit series, which is going to be a Let's Play I never quite finished before. Going up Tuesday, Thursday, whenever I have them recorded. You know, not required to have them recorded. And today we're going to be playing Fallout New Vegas. This time, we're going to be playing the vanilla game. Mostly. I have installed... I forget the name of it, but it's the complete fixed version of the mod that one of the creators of the game actually created that tweaked hardcore mode quite a bit. So yeah, I'm going to be playing hardcore on very hard as the modder recommended, and I'm also going to be using... I know this is going to make people sigh and roll their eyes. A controller. It's mainly just for the nostalgia of the first time I played Fallout 3, which was on the 360, but let's start.
Never changes. When atomic fire consumed the Earth, those who survived did so in great underground vaults. When they opened, their inhabitants set out across the ruins of the old world to build new societies, establishing villages, forming tribes. As decades passed, what had been the American Southwest united beneath the flag of the new California Republic, dedicated to old world values of democracy and the rule of law. As the Republic grew, so did its needs. Scouts spread east, seeking territory and wealth in the dry and merciless expanse of the Mojave Desert. They returned with tales of a city untouched by the warheads that had scorched the rest of the world, and a great wall spanning the Colorado River. The NCR mobilized its army and sent it east to occupy Hoover Dam and restore it to working condition. But across the Colorado, another society had arisen under a different flag. A vast army of slaves forged from the conquest of 86 tribes, Caesar's Legion. 4 years have passed since the Republic held the dam, just barely, against the Legion's onslaught. The Legion did not retreat. Across the river, it gathers strength. Campfires burn, training drums beat. Through it all, the New Vegas Strip has stayed open for business under the control of its mysterious overseer, Mr. House, and his army of rehabilitated tribals and police robots. You are a courier, hired by the Mojave Express to deliver a package to the New Vegas Strip. What seemed like a simple delivery job has taken a turn for the worse.
You got what you were after, so pay up.
You're crying in the rain, Pally.
Guess who's waking up over here?
Time to cash out.
Will you get it over with?
Maybe cons kill people without looking them in the face. But I ain't a fink. Dig? You've made your last delivery, kid. Sorry you got twisted up in this scene. From where you're kneeling, must seem like an 18-carat run of bad luck. Truth is, the game was rigged from the start.
You're awake. How about that? Whoa, easy there, easy. You've been out cold a couple of days now. Why don't you just relax a second? Get your bearings. Let's see what the damage is. How about your name? Can you tell me your name?
So, funny thing right now. This is being recorded a couple of days after that intro. No real reason, I just wound up recording the rest of that video and decided I didn't really like the way it was going. It was going to be Drake.
I can't say it's what I'd have picked for you, but if that's your name, that's your name. I'm Doc Mitchell. Welcome to Good Spring. Now, I hope you don't mind, but I had to go rooting around there in your noggin to pull all the bits of lead out. I take pride in my needlework.
I initially thought, I can do a roleplay flavor with this one, but I like metagaming too much. Sure. You know what? Let's randomize a couple times. Sure.
Well, I got most of it right anyway. Stuff that mattered. Okay. No sense keeping you in bed anymore. Let's see if we can get you on your feet. Good. Why don't you walk down to the end of the room? Over by that vigor tester machine there. Take it slow now. It ain't a race.
You're looking good. I don't like having to pretend I don't know what's going on.
Give the figure to Esther a try. We'll learn right quick if you get back all your faculties.
Let's see. Nothing. Oh, empty. That sucks. Take all the food I need because I am going to be playing on hardcore. right, let's go ahead and build the character. I'm actually going to play a low strength character. High perception, slightly below average endurance, high charisma, high intelligence, above average agility. Yeah.
Yeah, that's a pretty standard score there, but after what you've been through, I'd say that's great news. Well, we know your vitals are good, but that don't mean them bullets didn't leave you nutter and a big one are dropping. What do you say you take a seat in my couch and we go through a couple of questions? See if your dogs are still barking. All right. I'm gonna say a word. I want you to say the first thing that comes to mind. Dog. House. Night. Enemy. Light. Mother. Okay. Now I got a few statements. I want you to tell me how much they sound like something you'd say. First one, conflict just ain't in my nature. I ain't given to relying on others for support. I'm always fixing to be the center of attention. I'm slow to embrace new ideas. I charge in to deal with my problems head on. Almost done here.
I forgot. What do you say you have a look at this? Kind of a long section.
Tell me what you see. Okay. How about this one? Last one.
Two bears high-fiving.
Well, that's all she wrote. I don't have nothing to compare it to, so maybe you'd better just have a look at the results. See if it all seems right to you.
Alright. So I'm going to take energy weapons, survival, and lockpicking. Energy weapons, I've never actually really done a run of 3 or New Vegas emphasizing them, so it's going to be interesting. Make lead weapons just money. Probably going to bump up lockpick as soon as I can, though. That's 14 skill points to unlock the level 50 safes, but that is actually really good. We'll see how many skill points I get.
Before I turn you loose, I need one more thing from you. I got a form for you to fill out so I can get a sense of your medical history. Just a formality. Ain't like I expect to find you got a family history of getting shot in the head.
I think I'm gonna take fast shot. And skilled.
All right, I guess that about does it. Come with me, I'll see you out.
Just because I'm metagaming doesn't necessarily mean I'm doing it well.
Here, these are yours. Was all you had on you when you was brought in. I hope you don't mind, but I gave the note a look. I thought it might help me find a next of kin. But it was just something about a platinum chip. Well, if you're heading back out there, you ought to have this. They call it a Pip-Boy. I grew up in one of them vaults they made before the war. We all got one. Ain't much use to me now, but you might want such a thing after what you've been through. I know what it's like having something taken from you. And put this on, too, so the locals don't pick on you for lacking modesty. Never was much my style, anyway. Don't mention it. It's what I'm here for. You should talk to Sunny Smiles before you leave town. She can help you learn to fend for yourself in the desert. She'll likely be at the saloon. I reckon some of the other folks at the saloon might be able to help you out, too. And the metal fella, Victor, who pulled you out of your grave. Anyway, you ever get hurt out there, you come right back. I'll fix you up. But try not to get killed anymore.
And like I said, hardcore mode. Difficulty very hard. Alright. Oops. Gonna have to get used to, you know, controller controls. Impacts. I guess I might as well have my knife hotkeyed. And of course I have all the DLC. Now I learned that you actually can't get in here without a key now. Will I be doing the DLC? This LP is going to be long enough. I might do them as separate playthroughs, like keep a save before the point of no return. But... And plus, I really don't like dead money at all. Alright.
Cheyenne, stay. Don't worry, she won't bite unless I tell her to. Yeah, I guess there's a thing or two I could show you. Sounds like you need all the help you can get after what they done to you. Meet me outside, behind the saloon.
One thing I don't like about New Vegas, you don't have iron sights on energy weapons.
Now, see the sarsaparilla bottles on the fence there? That's the right idea. Look down the sight. Try crouching down and staying still. It'll help your aim. Nice shot. Well, that's a start. But I don't reckon you came to me to learn to fight sarsaparilla bottles. Tell you what, I gotta go chase geckos away from our water supply anyway. Darn critters are attracted to it. Why don't you come along? Follow me. It's just down to the southeast a short ways.
I need the starting money. She really does have a striking resemblance to Moira Brown. until she opens her mouth. Then she's nothing like Moira. Moira was at least quirky. You're not really expected to constantly return to Good Springs the way you are, Megaton, so... I do kind of prefer when RPGs have a central city, though, or town or something.
Hear that up on the ridge behind me there? We got some geckos to clear out. Bunch of little monsters is what they are. Seems like Doc Mitchell treats more gecko bites than anything else. Let's see if we can get a little closer. If we move quietly, we can get the jump on them. More likely to hit something vital that way.
My sneak skill is Garbo. Luckily, I think their perception is also trash. Trash! Had to. Oh. Huh. I think they actually made the energy weapons fairly decent for... Wait. Was that aim assist? That was either aim assist or very convenient spread. Might as well get some clean water while I'm here. Sunny.
See? You're getting the hang of it. There's two more wells that still need clearing. You want, you can come along. It'd be worth a few caps to me. Shouldn't take more than a couple minutes, especially with two of us. Come with me.
More bullets to sell, because they have weight in hardcore mode. Is this a little cheesy? Yes. Is it smart? Also, yes. I do wonder if the mod added more crafting recipes. That was something I always felt was lacking in both of last gen's Fallout games, really.
Holy moly. If you hadn't come here like you done, I'd be a goner for sure. I came up here to draw water, but here, you should have what I got. You look thirsty.
Thank you. And thank you for the rep. Where are the others? Oh. Oh, that's just a sticker on the... So that's where the town drunk lives. Yes, game, I know how to VATS. I just tend to prefer not... I just tend to prefer not to. And I know that's someone I want dead anyway. No, that's a Wasteland Adventurer. I thought that was the Powder Ganger for some reason.
Now that was some good work. Even got a little exciting there at the end. Here's a little spending money for the trouble. One more thing I wanted to show you. Thought I might teach you about living off the land and making useful things for yourself. Interested? All right, then. We'll need a couple ingredients to get started. Gonna want some Xander root and a Brock flower. Let me think now. I know I've seen Brock flowers growing up at the graveyard, and I seem to remember there being Xander root over by the schoolhouse. Bring those on back to me, and we'll get cooking.
All right, then. I figure a little bit of extra experience won't hurt. Especially since I need to go to those places for looting anyway. See, I think because of skilled, I actually do have 41 lockpick. Not bad. Whoops, that was a waste. This is the kind of thing that I want my knife for. I can't believe I wasted a stim pack already. I mean, I know that I'll have plenty of those later, but they are kind of expensive at the start. I can't really afford to be too picky with looting at the start. It sucks that I can't really take advantage of the caravan shotgun. Let's actually get the frickin' Xander root. And then just sell crap. I like shotguns, but not this playthrough. I forget if there's a laser scatter gun in the game. I feel like there might be. I mean, if nothing else, there's probably one in GRA.
You must be the one Doc Mitchell was patching up. The way I heard it, I didn't think you'd be walking out of that office. I've got plenty of supplies for sale. Even got some weapon mods and special ammo. Well worth the caps, if you ask me. If you're hurting for caps, I've also got boxes of surplus ammo in the miscellaneous section. They're not great, but you get what you pay for. Can do.
Alright. Bullets. And shotgun shells. Let's see. Expired stim packs. Super stim pack. Okay, yeah, give me the plasma GRA. Any mods for the GRA one? Doesn't look like it, no. All right.
Give me a shout if you need anything else. Take it easy now.
Really used plasma weapons. It was always like, use the dinky little laser pistol in like, what was it? The Super Duper Mart. Ooh. Probably makes scrap metal. Stimpak, homemade, leather belt, mute fruit, and Nuka-Cola. Oh, that... Wait, no, that's the one. Brock flower, Xander root, and empty syringe. Okay, so if you have empty syringes, it's better than healing powder. Wait, incendiary rockets. Didn't think I was playing Borderlands. I'm definitely planning to revisit the Borderlands series as well. Really only a revisitation for the first game, I guess. Oh right, plasma uses multiple cells per shot. That was the wrong button. Do some weightless oblivion combat. Wait. There was an animation in there that looked really stupid. twirling the blade a little. I wasn't about to waste energy cells on bloat flies. God, no. There should be a snow globe around here. Unless those were moved. Oh dear God. Not going down there without some form of armor piercing. Or having 100 energy weapons. That'll also do it. And a heavily modded energy weapon. Hopefully a laser shotgun. Because now I'm fixed on how awesome a laser shotgun would be. It's been a while since I've played New Vegas, so forgive me if I'm rusty on, like, some areas or quests. Or items. In case anyone's wondering, I'm probably going to go the independent route with Yes Man. My love for crafting kinda has me looking forward to Elex, because I really like Piranha Bytes games. Even though I've never really played very far into any of them, I really love what I've played. They made the Risen and Gothic games, or at least the first three Gothic games. My friend Fluent is trying to power through all of their games before Elex comes out over at Fluent's World, so go ahead and check that out.
Let me see what you got. Yeah, these'll do just fine. Just fine. Alright now. We're gonna be making something folks on the trail call healing powder. Go on over to that campfire now. Give it a try.
Well, first, convert my ingredients into decent food.
Hey, that's not bad, see? All it takes to make a recipe is the right ingredients and the right know-how. Sometimes it won't be a campfire you need. Might need to do some work on your guns and ammo, maybe. Important thing to get is it's all the same idea. You just need to find the right place to set up shop. Workbench or reloading bench, whatever. Well, I hope that's enough to get you started. I'm heading back now. Hope I didn't miss anything good on the jukebox. Cheyenne would never forgive me. Hey, do me a favor. Trudy, she's the bartender up at the Prospector. Kind of the town mom. She likes to meet newcomers. She'd be cross with me if I didn't ask you to poke your head in and say hi.
Alright. This should trigger the Powder Ganger quest. Anyway, I don't really have much to talk about right now. E3's around the corner. That's fun. There's just something exciting about seeing so many new games announced at once. Like a Christmas in June. Still haven't actually gotten to play Persona 5. Don't even own it yet. I have a feeling I will be playing that non-stop, though.
I'm done being nice. If you don't hand Ringo over soon, I'm going to get my friends and we're burning this town to the ground. Got it?
We'll keep that in mind. Now, if you're not going to buy something, get out.
What the hell is your problem?
Well, you've been causing quite a stir. Glad I finally got to meet you. Welcome to the Prospector Saloon.
Let's see.
Got a special discount for you after what you've done for us.
Do I have anything to sell, really? A couple of those. Five of those. Three of those. Oh, wow, that's actually worth a lot. And, but that's really good. You can't. Right, you don't actually have any ammo. Alright.
Another satisfied customer. Looks like our little town got itself dragged in the middle of something we don't want anything to do with. About a week ago, this traitor, Ringo, comes into town. Survivor of an attack, he says. Bad men after him. Needs a place to hide. We figured he was just in shock, so we gave him a place to lie low. We didn't actually expect anyone to come after him. He's holed up at the abandoned gas station up the hill. Some of the others, like Sonny, will probably stand up for Ringo if he asks for help, which he hasn't. Personally, I hope he sneaks out of town one night and takes the Powder Gangers with him. Chain gangs, really. The NCR brought them in from California to work on the rail lines. Problem is, it turns out that giving convicts a bunch of dynamite and blasting powder isn't the best idea. It was a big escape not too long ago. Some of them stuck together so they could make trouble. That's what we're dealing with now. All right. Be careful out there.
And of course, I'm going the good route because I just can't be evil in games. Wait, I need the key to the...
Feeling thirsty?
Gas station.
If you were able to get Ringo out of this mess, you'd have a decent reputation around Good Springs. I'd even set you up with a discount. Of course, helping Ringo would also make the Powder Gangers mad. And they've got a lot of friends out there.
Maybe it's just locked until I do that conversation. Let's give it a shot. Door two, in the head, like me. Oh, it was just locked until now.
That's close enough. Who are you, and what do you want with me?
Sorry about the gun. You just caught me off guard, that's all. We got off to a bad start. What say we start over with a friendly game of Caravan? You know how to play?
Nope, not touching Caravan.
Yeah, he doesn't look very tough, though. I hear he's afraid I'll shoot him down from one of the windows when I see him. And he's right. I'll have a much bigger problem once his friends show up. There's no way I could handle all of them in a gunfight. My caravan was on the return trip from California and heading back to the company branch in New Vegas when we got jumped. Not even a drop your weapons and hands up before the bullets started flying. We put up a good fight, but there was too many of them. I took a few of the bandits down before I ran, so I figure their friends are out for revenge. I'm gonna lay low for as long as I can, assuming the town doesn't throw me to the wolves. I've got no chance against the gang on my own. All I've got left on me are a handful of caps, but you get me out of this and I'll make sure the Crimson Caravan pays you back. You've got my word. We'd just end up sharing the same grave if it's just the two of us. Now, if some of the other people in town were also on board... Start with Sunny Smiles. She's been friendlier than most around here.
I'm gonna do the looting because you didn't. You are terrible at this wasteland thing. Teenage wasteland. No, no, the words. You are really bad at this wasteland thing. Oh. Yeah, that's take mine. It back. I realized too late that was owned. I don't actually think I have the stats for... No, I actually might have the stat for Easy Pete. I forget if it's 26 or 30. And then I'm gonna need a magazine for Chet. But I think... Let's see, I'm meeting people... Salesman Weekly, okay.
Hi there. Sticking around Good Springs for a while longer?
Say no more. I'm in.
Joe Cobb talks about leaving us alone if we hand over Ringo, but I know his type. He and his friends will come after the town eventually. However, between you, me, and Ringo, we aren't exactly a force to be reckoned with. A lot of people around here look up to Trudy. If you could convince Trudy to join us, some of the folks in town might decide to help out as well. I know Easy Pete's got a stack of dynamite somewhere, and Chet just got a shipment of leather armor we could borrow. Talk to them as well. Finally, there's a good chance we'll all end up with extra holes in us. So if Doc Mitchell could cough up some extra stim packs, that'd be great. I'll be waiting.
So you're planning on taking on Joe Cobb's gang. It's a big risk, but I suppose you have to do what you think is right. I was planning on sitting this one out, but for some reason, I can't help but like you. I'm with you. Let me have a word with a few other folks, and I'll see if I can't round up some more members for this militia you're creating. While everyone does own a gun, we could stand to be a little better equipped. The general store probably has what we need in stock.
I just noticed she has a revolver in the glass back there.
Be careful out there.
Alright, let's bump up explosives to 30 just in case. And dump the rest into energy weapons. I'm 1 point away from the next level of speech check with medicine, so I'll take it. I guess I'll go ahead and take Hunter. Since apparently my sneak crits are awesome.
You looking to buy some supplies? Now just hold on. I never voted to take on the Powder Gangers. That's a 1,000 cap investment you're talking about. Right. Take it easy now.
I don't have a medicine magazine, so honestly, I think this is a better
one. You looking to buy some supplies?
To use a magazine on.
This again? Like I said, I'm against taking on the Powder Gangers. My supplies aren't cheap, you know. You made your point. I can provide people with some leather armor and extra ammo. Sure hope it's worth it. And I'll be guarding the store while all this is going on. I have to put my business first. You understand. Take it easy now.
Alright, Easy Pete is out here.
Howdy. What can Easy Pete do for you? Too dangerous. Gonna kill all yourselves if I let you touch it. Better to leave it buried. Safer that way. Uh-huh. Guess you know what you're doing. I'll go dig it up and get it ready. You'll have it by the time the fighting starts. Keep your gun handy if you go poking around some of the abandoned places around here, like the schoolhouse. Critters move in there sometimes.
I noticed. I think this is the first time I've actually had everyone's support in this quest.
Welcome back. I had hoped you wouldn't need to come see me again so soon. What can I do for you? Seems like wherever I go, it's always the same. Folks just never leave each other alone. Oh, I'm not much good in a fight with my bum leg. And my supplies are scarce, but I'll give you what I can spare.
Oh, I didn't realize there
you take
was
care now.
No check with him. Alright, well, I don't know how long I've been recording, so I guess next time we're gonna defend Good Springs and head on to Prim. See you guys then.